The Fallout franchise certainly has its fair share of brilliant iconography. One of the most exemplary pieces of equipment to come out of the series would have to be the Robco Personal Information Processor, otherwise known as the Pip-Boy. Within every Fallout game, the player, alongside many other vault dwellers, have received one of these for their wrist, gaining all the advantages it brings. The Pip-Boy may be as iconic to the series as the likes of Deathclaws, Supermutants, or even Vault Boy bobbleheads, but I'm here to ask and hopefully answer a very interesting question. Is it possible, or more to the point, could we recreate a device that acts almost exactly the same as a Pip-Boy but in our real world? To answer that, we need to learn exactly what its purpose was in the Fallout universe and what items we'd need to check off to build our very own iteration of this wrist eye candy. As we found out in Fallout 3, when a person has their 10th birthday in a vault, they receive a Pip-Boy, which is almost universal to the other iterations in the franchise. It's used as a sign of progression towards adulthood and having responsibilities, therefore it helps the user organise themselves and their equipment. It has the function to track and store any and all items the player character picks up. Obviously, this game mechanic is completely unrealistic, and unless you want a giant bag dangling from your wrist, this function of the Pip-Boy isn't going to come close. As for keeping track of yourself, well, that's a different story. A group of individuals at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology have delivered to us a pill-shaped device that through audio waves can track your vital signs and feedback to a computer or other device. You simply consume it like you would a regular pill, like for example a paracetamol, and bingo, it's in. The device then slowly goes down your gastrointestinal tract through your internal systems and then lies on your stomach for a few days, collecting and distributing data about your heart's beat per minute along with the respiratory rate. Honestly, it's a little difficult to read as an outsider. However, I'm sure once you become accustomed to reading the acoustic waves of your insides, you'll know what's what and whether you'll just straight up fall over and die in the immediate future, or you'll live through another dreadful day in the harsh wastes. Although it is a very useful piece of wireless technology to keep track of your vital signs, it's not a permanent option since it pops out your poop chute after a short period of time. So, it may not be a completely viable option, but I digress. Moving on to another very useful portion of the Pip-Boy's abilities, mapping out areas. In the Fallout games, you can locate a local map for smaller areas such as inside buildings, or a world map to view the whole playable area in the game, with location marks on the places that the Pip-Boy recognises that you've been to. There is always the option to fast travel to said places, but I think we all know that that's literally the game just skipping or simulating the walk there for you. So, a map that can track your location. Well, a simple solution would be a portable satellite GPS system strapped to your wrist for convenience. A good example of this would be the Garmin eTrax 10 GPS outdoor handheld. It's simple to use, it's reasonably small, and guess what, you can even put in your own locations that you want to go to or places you've been, so you can check map markers off the list. We've got a pill to track our health and a GPS duct taped to our wrist for mapping, but that's not much of a Pip-Boy, right? Well, don't worry your little head, because Ashley Hennifer and her Space Apps team have us covered. They've been inspired by the Fallout series so much, they've decided to give a little back and try and do my job for me. But they've actually got the physical talent, the know-how and resources to actually do it. And so they did. Sure, it doesn't solve our inventory problem, but that shit ain't getting solved unless you have a personal robot butler following you around carrying all of your possessions everywhere you go. They have, however, 3D printed out a model of the Pip-Boy, reminiscent of the Pip-Boy 3000, and thrown a bunch of cool shit into it. Whilst on your wrist, it has the capability of live mapping, showing you your surroundings whilst updating where you go on the move, which is exactly how it functions in the game. The only difference is, you can't click a button on this and it magically does the walking for you. That would just be outstanding when that day comes. They've also implemented a homemade but fully tested and accurate Geiger counter for those radioactive situations we always encounter in the Fallout games, so you won't have to worry about venturing into that steamy yellow cave too much. I mean, you'll probably still die, but at least you'll know how much you're dying at a time. There were also plans, as you can see, to develop it further to track your vitals alongside ambient temperature, relative humidity, atmospheric pressure, as well as object temperature using an infrared thermometer. They may have actually gone back to finish these touches off, but they were unable to completely finish it during the SpaceApp's 48-hour development marathon, and I can't seem to find out where they are with it today, which is a bit of a shame. I can tell you that they had even higher goals with their Pip-Boy improving on its in-game variant, by adding not just a radio to listen to, like in the games, but a radio device to communicate with other wastelanders and settlements. All of this data, gathered from the sensors and for changing the frequency, was fully developed and viewed on a touchscreen of an old iPhone. The data is then distributed to and from a hub device or just a mainframe computer, through a TIBLE sensor, which is just a really efficient Bluetooth system that doesn't completely drain your battery too quickly. And voila, a Pip-Boy is born. So, they've effectively got everything covered, with their last plan set in stone to attempt to configure a Bluetooth EEG heart rate monitor to track your vital signs and progress from there. I think the last thing we need to do now is provide an alternative to the vault-tec assisted targeting system, otherwise known as VATS. For those who don't know, in the majority of the Fallout games, VATS has acted like a time stop button, to allow the user to plan out their attack and aim for a distinct body part rather than just an enemy in general. It has become a very useful staple gameplay mechanic for the franchise, and has only really improved as the games have evolved. So, can we stop time? Or, like in Fallout 4, engage in bullet time? No. Unless you trip some serious balls on some fucking weird ass drugs, you ain't gonna perceive time anywhere near that slow. What about targeting individual body parts? Well, yes and no. There are some automated turret systems that can target at specific body parts under certain conditions to immobilize the target, but as for use with a single human unit, no, we cannot. We can, however, create an outline of potential targets, which will mostly come in handy during the darker periods of your time in the wasteland. We can do this by using a technology that has been around and used for the past few decades, but has only recently been perfected. That being thermal sensorial rifle scopes. I know what you're thinking, this ain't gonna be attached to my wrist, alongside the rest of my gear. It is sort of the next best thing though. Just stick it onto your gun, aim and you're good to go. That's DIY style. So there you have it, a makeshift Pip-Boy. It's certainly possible, bar the inventory carrying situation and true VATS experience, but after that we can almost make a perfect replica from the game to the real world. So yes, we can create a Pip-Boy. I know a few people were asking for this one and I have been wanting to do it for a while, so I do hope you guys have enjoyed. If you did, you can support the creation of more of these shows on our Patreon, or simply do us a solid and share this video with all of your friends. If you have any suggestions for future tech episodes or just any videos you would like me to do in general, you can get a direct link to me on Twitter at @StallysMilitia. It should be up on the screen right now. So make sure to hit me up. And if you want any more of me in general, there's plenty dotted around the channel. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Andrew or Stally111. And make sure to drop a like, drop a comment, and subscribe if you've not done so already. And I'll see you later.